Got some exciting new kit to try on my back. The new Impress 4.
Welcome to the Flybubble Paragliding channel.
We are free flight experts and equipment specialists helping you get the best flying experience.
Hi there. This is Carlo from Flybubble. Just popping out to the hill. Got some exciting new kit to try. The new full top of the range competition and cross country harness. First harness from Advance with a full fairing, a full tail spoiler for aerodynamics. Two reserve containers left and right. Full size flight deck and many other features besides. But what's it like to fly? That's what I want to know. So I'm going to go and try it now. Excuse the heavy breathing. Trying to catch up Nancy. Cumulus clouds inland, blue skies towards the coast. So, looks like it's looking good. Sea breeze has pulled through, fingers crossed. So as you can see, the Impress 4 comes with its own special edition of the Advanced Comfort Pack 3 rucksack, 130 litres. You can see here, opening up the rucksack, got my helmet and my instruments, and there's loads of space, very, very easy to fit everything in there. Definitely less compressible than the Lightness 3. The protection feels, I think it's bigger, and a bit more solid, and obviously you've got the seat plate as well. I've left the seat plate in. Okay, so now getting it out of the bag. There's the harness. There we go. It's been quite unusual for this kind of level of harness. Advance have made it so that there's a split here, so you can actually fold the harness on top, which is not really possible with any other comparable harness. It's part of the reason it packs so compactly. So here we have it on the left side. I've not fitted a reserve in the second side yet, and you can see that's the tube that's specially made for inflating the rear fairing. See how that inflates later. The other side, I fitted a companion SQR light reserve in here. I only had a 120 available, I would have fitted 100 otherwise, but that's in there. That's fitted in obviously really nicely. So here's the cockpit, very nicely shaped. This is the part if you want to add the windscreen in. Over here, I've actually added my flight panel off my Lightness 3. That doesn't come with the harness. I've just, for laziness and convenience, I've just stuck that on there. This whole thing zips right off. So the zip goes all the way around and the whole part comes off, which is nifty. It's got a really nice tag on it, which makes it really easy to do. Even in flight, you'll be able to open that, get into there. Inside, it really is like they've made this harness for me. So here they've got a nice neoprene part which you can pull out and say, for example, just to cover your instruments, but also say you're flying and it started drizzling on you or something like that, you can cover your instruments up, which is a nice idea. Underneath here, if you look there, then in here is an extra space, and here you can put your battery packs, your battery bank, and there's your holes for your cables to go through. There's another hole in the middle here, so your battery bank or banks, depending on how many you need, go there, and then those holes are revealed under here, and there's 1, 2, 3, play the little game. Lanyard attachments, I end up putting a little key ring holders on there, very lightweight, and I get these little metal hooks which are very cheap but work very well. Some people might not like hooks, but there we go. And I can just stick my Lightness 3 panel on there really nicely. Okay, so now opening up the back pocket. Inside is the part for the fairing in there. And here we have the pocket. There's a little small pocket for putting your wallet and stuff there. There's the main pocket there to put your rucksack and whatnot in there. Tiny little tip for you, when you get a brand new glider, or the gliders that have been away for a while, quite often the risers end up very tight like this. And yeah, you try and get them on there and it's like, don't get on. So just a tiny little tip, just stick your finger in, make them wider, and then they'll slip on much more easily. Okay, so I just had my very first flight from the Empress 4 harness, and conditions are a little breezy, and so I've had to come down and fly low on the slope to be safe, and so it's kind of tricky working in the little slope, but the harness gives you a really good feeling of connection with the glider, super comfortable, really like it, very nice first impressions. Look forward to trying it more.
How was that?
Very good. Jolly good.
Very nice.
So in summary, the Empress 4 is beautifully made, supremely comfortable, and hugely enjoyable to fly with. The features are fantastic. It's got everything that an ambitious cross-country or even competition pilot could want. The reserve system is really well done and very easy to deploy if you need that, and works very well on both sides. There's plenty of storage in the back of the harness, in the front, and there's some extra space underneath the seat as well, which you can also use for ballast. The speed system, the pulleys on it are really great. So one of the main reasons to fly with a harness like this, the top end, the high end competition harnesses, which not everyone realizes, it's not just about the aerodynamics of that it's got a streamlined shape. That's obviously important, performance is an important factor, but one of the most important reasons that to fly a harness like this is they actually make the glider more stable. The harness is, it's got a lot of stiffness in the length of it, and that stiffness in the harness, the structural integrity, gives you more cohesiveness between the harness and the wing. When you have a harness, the lighter pod harnesses, especially the lightest ones, which have very little structure and move around quite a bit, well, that moving around in the harness quite a bit tends to make the glider move around more. So having a more stable harness like this makes the glider more stable. So yeah, this kind of harness, it's for a pilot that's looking for top performance, top safety, and top comfort, and doesn't mind carrying a bit more weight to get that. For epic cross-country days where you're going to try and fly as far as possible, then this is the harness that I would choose to fly in without a shadow of a doubt.